lot of the bigger fish which run along these edges are tuned in to finding baitfish which look like they're wounded or injured or isolated. And the idea of using a lure like this is to create exactly that impression. This lure skitters across the top, creates a lot of wake, and looks like a baitfish that's on its own, it's out of sorts and it's running away, and it's often too much for them to resist. Let's put it into action. Mackerel have been frustrating us so far, particularly the big ones. This time.
Got him.
Got him.
Oh, you champion.
Oh, nice one, mate.
You legend.
Hey, look at that.
The Spanish mackerel. The biggest of our mackerel species and one of your favourite fish, mate.
Undoubtedly.
And they are, just have a look at the face on them, just that sharp nose. Serious, serious teeth, and they all mesh together. They've got massive bursts of speed. We've already seen them getting airborne, which just shows you the speeds they can reach. And they get up to 60 kilos around the planet, so they're a serious, serious predator. Well done, mate.
Bloody ripper.
That mackerel that Hamish has just caught has regurgitated a baitfish, and there's some very cool factors involved with the size of the baitfish and the lure he was using, and I want to show you right now what we talk about when we say you need to match the hatch, you need to closely imitate the bait that you think the fish are feeding on. He could not have got it any closer if he tried. This is the fish that he's coughed up. You notice the tail hanging off because they're so good at chopping fish up as they take him into mouth. And then lying it side by side with the lure that he's using, could not have better imitated it if he tried.